What's up, designers? Welcome back to Rempton Games. Today we're going to be doing another Pokemon theme team video, this time with the theme of winter holidays. These are not all holidays that I personally celebrate, so I did my best to represent them all faithfully. If there's something that I got wrong or something that I missed, please let me know in the comments down below. Without further ado, let's get started with the easiest one for me personally, which is Christmas. So Christmas, in case you're not familiar with it, is a holiday celebrated on December 25th that represents the birth of baby Jesus. It's a very important holiday in Christianity, but it's also just celebrated around the world as a day for giving gifts and things. Not always necessarily connected with the Christian holiday. It's a very big holiday, especially here in the United States, but I know it's also celebrated all around the world, and let's get into it. So the Christmas team was pretty straightforward. Of course, we're gonna have Delibird here, who's basically already Santa Claus, right? And I chose Mime Jr. here to represent his elf. You know, he's got the pointed hat, he's very happy. I think Mime Jr. makes a good Christmas elf. Then we got Stantler, who's a pretty straightforward reindeer. We got Abomasnow, who I thought would make a good Christmas tree, right? He's a snowy kind of a pine tree. I couldn't think of anything that was sort of a toy Pokemon, but I did get Rolycoly, who represents getting coal in your stocking if you're a bad child, if you're on the naughty list, right? Finally, I got Jirachi here to represent the Christmas star from the story of baby Jesus that was over the manger, and also kind of to represent the star that goes on top of the Christmas trees. So yeah, that is the Christmas team. So next we have the Hanukkah team. So Hanukkah is a holiday that's important in Jewish traditions. Hanukkah is celebrating the rededication of the Jewish temple, where one day's worth of oil ended up burning for 8 days. And once again, this is another holiday that I personally don't celebrate, but I did my best to represent it as faithfully as I could. So of course we have Chandelure here to represent the menorah and the candles. And since Hanukkah represents a rededication of the Jewish temple, I decided to have Stakataka here actually represent the temple itself. Then I had Hitmontop here to represent the dreidel, the traditional spinning top. I have Meowth to represent the tradition of giving gold coins. Oil seems to be a big part of Hanukkah traditions, so that's why I have Alolan Muk here, because Alolan Muk kind of represents an oil spill. I know it's not exactly the same kind of oil, but I thought that would be a decent representation there. And finally, baked goods seem to be a major part of celebrating the holiday, so that's why I have Slurpuff here. Moving on, our next holiday is Kwanzaa. So Kwanzaa is a more recent holiday. I think it was founded in the 1960s. And it's basically celebrated as a way to kind of celebrate African culture and African heritage, particularly among African Americans in the United States. So once again, another holiday I don't personally celebrate, so let me know if I got something wrong, but I tried to represent as faithfully as I could. So once again, we have a chandelier to represent the arrangement of candles, which is a big part of celebrating Kwanzaa. I chose to go for a shiny chandelier in this case to, one, to just differentiate them. Two, red, green, and black seem to be an important color scheme for this holiday. Shiny chandelier better represents that color scheme. I thought it was a better fit overall. Fruits and vegetables seem to be symbolic of the Kwanzaa holiday, So I got a fruit here with Applin, and then Farfetch'd is holding a leek to represent the vegetables. Another symbol of Kwanzaa is the Unity Cup. So I have Synesty here to represent that. And finally, I have Unpheasant to once again kind of represent that red, black, and green color scheme. There aren't too many Pokemon that actually have that color scheme. And because a big part of Kwanzaa is just celebrating, you know, African heritage and everything, I chose to represent that here with Pyroar. So that is Kwanzaa. And the next holiday is New Year's. New Year's Day is celebrated all around the world to represent the beginning of a new year, and it's celebrated in a lot of different cultures, but not every culture necessarily celebrates it on the same day. Not every culture necessarily uses the same calendar. So for this picture, I'm not being particular about any specific New Year's, and I'm bringing together lots of different traditions from New Year's cultures all around the world. So the first one, we got Blacephalon here to represent fireworks. That's a very traditional way of celebrating. And we have Smoochum to represent one of my favorite New Year's traditions, which is kissing somebody at midnight. A New Year's tradition in some European countries, I think Spain, is to eat 12 grapes. And there aren't any grape Pokemon, but I thought Cherubi was pretty close with cherries. You know, it's kind of like a bunch of grapes. So then moving to Japan, there's a tradition of ringing a bell 108 times, I think. So we got Bronzong to represent that bell. And then for Chinese New Year, I have Drampa to represent the dragon that gets paraded through the streets. And I chose Shiny Duskull to represent the traditional red lanterns. Finally, we have Thanksgiving, which is a holiday celebrated in the United States at the end of November. And it's mainly celebrated through a big feast. It's one of the biggest eating days in the American calendar. It represents settlers who first arrived at Plymouth Rock, having a big meal after their first successful harvest. So we have Fearow to represent a turkey. There's not really a turkey Pokemon, so I thought Fearow was about as good of a representation as we could get. Traditional Thanksgiving foods include pies, so that's why we have Appleton. And I also have Pumpkaboo to represent pumpkins, to kind of represent the season of Thanksgiving. And once I got to that point, I basically just started adding all of the food Pokemon that I haven't used already. So, of course, we got Flapple, we have Alcremie for desserts, and also we have Vanillux, who is a lot bigger than I thought he was. And yeah, so this is our delicious Thanksgiving feast. That's all I have for this time. Please let me know if you have any suggestions or anything that I missed for these holidays or for any other holidays that I couldn't fit into the video. And also please leave me suggestions for future entries in this series, for future topics that you would like me to make Pokemon teams for. Until then, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.